ICU post 1 patient is intubated. Okay, the patient will be mostly intubated. Okay, after the surgery, usually endotracheal tubings will be there, IC lines will be there, CV lines will be there, central lines will be there, peripheral lines will be there. Okay, so all those lines will be there. In that, at times the patient is not conscious, you need to perform this. Relax, don't do anything, I will do it. Okay, just relax. If the patient is not conscious, you have to do passive movements. Support the arm and do the passive movements. Okay, like this. Okay, your position will be passive movements, will be like this, and you have to do passive movements. Okay, move the fingers. Okay, stabilize the wrist, move the fingers, hand. Okay, and then this. Okay, remember, you are not going to give any shoulder movements. Okay, maybe if he is not till here, okay, don't go like this and do like this. Is contraindicated in surgery till maybe this level, maybe 45 degrees maximum, not more than that. Okay, then you have to give them ankle pump exercises. Okay, just do ankle toe exercises. Okay, 15 to 20 times. Do down, pull up, full down, full up. Okay, if he is conscious, he is following your command. If he is not conscious, you have to passively hold and do the movement. Okay, then if he is following your command, maybe from day 1, day 2, what you can start is leg slides. Slide straight, slide straight. Okay, give 5 times here. Have a watch on the vitals. Every time you need to watch the vitals when you are giving exercises, because he is extremely in a danger condition. That's why he is in the ICU. Okay, this leg. Okay, so this is how we will start upper range of motion. Though I have written 90 degree, but you make it to 45 degrees. Okay, because it is all the clinical reasoning. Some people have the expertise. Once they see the patient, they know, yes, he can do it. Okay, that's because of their expertise, 10 years, 20 years they are in the profession. But as you will be the new starters, you should just make it to 45 and see how the patient is tolerating. You should ask, are you getting any pain? Are you getting anything? Okay. Once you are teaching huffing or coughing to the patient, his sutures should be all splinted. Splinted means give a towel, ask him to splint with hands. Okay, one hand like this or this, and then perform the huffing or coughing. Okay, these are protocols you need to remember. Level 1 starts, it's a very minimal energy expenditure phase. Okay, 1 to 1.5 mets. Mets is usually the unit by which we measure the energy expenditure in us. Usually our energy expenditure in a day is, normally it is 6 to 8 mets. That's all. Okay, so we need to make the patient reach at least 6 to 8 mets so that he can meet his daily living demands. Okay, so arm support, medial. Okay, so what we'll do is, so any meals where we are placing, usually in hospitals there are special tables that will place them like this, and they will perform a table like this. Okay, and the meals will be placed and the patient will be asked to eat. First day and all, the caretakers or the nurses, they will do it. But from the first, second day and all, patient himself should start doing it. Okay, and then come to the side of the bed. These are all bed mobility exercises. Okay, so you can ask the patient to come in case, let's go back, in case you feel he is not healthy enough or strong enough. Okay, you need to support the arm. Move slowly. Yes. Are you comfortable? Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Need to keep asking the patient, are you feeling okay? Are you feeling any dizziness? Okay, you need to keep asking the patient every time. Okay, ask him to do ankle pump movements in this position. Okay, so he will do ankle pump movements demonstrate it to the patient. This is ankle pump movement. See my feet. Do the same. Okay? We come to the level 2. We increase again the energy demands. Okay? Sitting 15 to 30 minutes 2 to 4 times a day. That means sitting becomes lazim. He has to sit more often. Okay? So we need to he is only sitting in the chair. Okay? Before, like he was sitting in the bed. Now he has to sit in the chair. Okay? So we ask the patient, usually by this phase, patient will be able to get up. Okay? Just get up. Okay? So getting up is very important. Okay? So when you are getting up, you need to do like this, reach your feet. Okay? Minimal pressure on the shoulder. Okay? And bend little bit in front and then get up. Understood? Very important. Okay? So when I am asking you get up, you are not normal. You will not just get up like this and come and sit like this. No. Major surgery has happened. So how you get up? You will ask them to move their buttocks. So slowly he will roll one buttock, second buttock, third, fourth, reach the ground. Feet are touching. Okay? Feet are touching, he will take support through the feet, bend little bit forward, apply minimal pressure on the palm or the hands and then get up like this. And then he will stand like this. Okay? By this time, you should be catching the radial pulse. Okay? Ask him to come slowly and be seated. Okay, sit down. Okay. So you have to have some watch on the vitals. Suddenly if you feel it is becoming too much the heart rate is increasing too much, the pulse rate is increasing too much, or you say you are getting kind of broods, you have to be careful. You have to document it and inform the sisters. Okay? Let him sit supportedly. So he is having a pillow behind. You should not lean too much back. You should be sitting in front. Okay? And you should perform it 15 to 30 minutes. That means 3 to 4 times. So morning, okay, lunch, tea time in the evening, night time before sleeping, you should also sit. Then you should sit. So that's it, 4. Okay. So reclining upright chair, limited ADL, electric razor, he can use electric razor. Okay. If he is not able to use, you have to do it because sutures are still there and it's a very early phase. Okay. You need to take care of the and then limited ambulation. So limited ambulation, whenever you are doing, you need to hold the pulse. Okay. So when you will be walking, okay. So first two steps, 1, 2, this is 2, okay, you will be breathing, okay, next one step you will be breathing out, okay. So every first step you will be breathing in, every two steps you will be breathing out. Okay, 1:2. Inspiratory ratio to expiratory ratio is 1:2. Okay, so same way we will be teaching the patient so that while walking he should not get breathless. So what we will do, we will just make him walk around the bed. Okay, keep a watch on his pulse. Okay, so every one step take in breath, every two steps take out breath. So like this we will be making him walk. Make sure there is no obstacle. Okay, are you okay? Are you feeling dizzy?
No.
Is there any other problem that you are facing?
No.
Okay. Then make him sit. Okay. So this is how you do the level 2. Okay. Level 3, limited hall ambulation. Okay. So that means this was just around the bed. Limited hall means you will go in the hall. Keep a watch on his respiratory rate, at the same time the pulse rate, okay, and make him watch, keep a watch on his symptoms, keep asking the patients. Okay. So what all activities you can do? Standing leg exercises, sit outside of the bed or in the bathroom to wash, manual shave, bathroom privileges, independent or assisted ambulation. So you can also ask the caretakers to be with you when you are performing the training. Level 4, 2.5 to 3 minutes. That means energy consumption is around 2.5 to 3 minutes. Okay. So hall ambulation 5 to 7 minutes as tolerated 3 to 4 times a day. So that you are seeing the hall ambulation is increasing. So what is this hall ambulation? Okay. You have a corridor. Okay. So you make the patient walk in this corridor. Okay. You have at least, I think, maybe 50 meters. Okay. So you make them walk in this 50 meter to and fro. Okay. At least 3 to 4 times a day. Remember, when the patient is walking, okay, you will keep a watch always on the pulse. You will have a watch or a mobile. Through that, you will keep watching the pulse for 1 minute. Make him walk throughout at least 3 to 4 rounds. Okay. Ask the patient every one step breathe in, every two steps breathe out. Initially, he might not be able to do it, but slowly he will be able to do it. Once you bring him to the bed, it is mandatory, it is lazim to measure his blood pressure. Okay, if blood pressure has fallen too much, okay, then we need to be precautious, we need to inform the sisters and the physicians also. Okay, so hall ambulation is now 8 to 10 minutes, arm exercise protocol may start depending how is the healing. Once the physician, the primary surgeon says healing is good, start the shoulder exercise. We have to start the shoulder exercise from level 5. Okay. Remember, till 90 degree only. Okay. Even if you are bringing, it should be till 90 degree only. You should not go like this. This is wrong. Okay. Level 6, stair climbing. Okay. So flight of stairs. Okay, he need to climb flight of stairs up and down. Remember, you will be watching the pulse rate and the RR and as well as the facial expression. If they are going into distress, they will give expressions. You have to note down, you have to ask them, is it okay? Or if they are feeling dizzy, they will give expression like this. You have to hold them, make them seated. So you should also have a caretaker or the assistant. In case you are mobilizing, they should take care. So one floor, flight of stairs, up and down, one step at a time. So one step they climb, they wait. Then again they climb, they wait. Okay? You are watching the pulse and the RR. Pointers, you are watching every time. So this is a surgery we undergo. Okay? After usually the ICU phase, they will extubate them. So speech therapist will also come to retrain their speech because they will be having a lot of abrasions in the vocal cord because the tube will be entered. Okay. So make sure you are giving all these exercises after extubation, deep breathing exercises. Okay, we have taught you diaphragmatic breathing. Okay, relaxed diaphragmatic breathing. We have taught you deep breathing. What you have to do is ask the patient to take in deep breath like this. And then when he has taken to the maximum capacity, just hold it for 1 or 2 seconds and then the exhalation should be passive, should not be forceful. Okay? So what I mean by passive is naturally the air that is coming out. Okay? Forceful is like this. This is wrong. You should not exert. Your therapy should induce a lot of relaxation. Relaxation will induce good healing. Okay? So this deep breathing why we are giving to open up all the collapsed or eclectic alveoli. Okay? Incentive spirometer. Incentive spirometer is a device with 3 balls. Okay? And it is very mandatory that it should be started on the first day itself. Okay? Don't keep them in excess. Okay, excess of incentive spirometry will cause hyperventilation. So as soon as the extubation is there, extubation means the endotracheal tube or the tracheostomy tube is taken out, it's being closed. Okay, so you have to give them and ask them to suck in air. And the balls are there, they have to raise at least 2 balls or 1.5 balls. By the time of discharge, they should be able to raise 2 balls. Coughing, sneezing, laughing, you see the picture, it should be all splendid. Okay. Coughing will start from day 0 itself. If the patient is conscious, oriented, it will start from day 0, splendid coughing. Okay. External precautions, you are seeing not to exert pressure like this when you are getting up. This is wrong. Okay. If you are putting pressure like this, you are eventually transferring the pressure to the middle of the sternum, that will break the sutures open. So this is wrong. Okay. So proper bed transfer is very, very important. Okay. So use of crutches, lying on the hand, these all should be precautions, should be taken till 6 to 8 weeks. Okay. Sternal precaution is very important because sternal infections are very common. So hemodynamic monitoring, okay. Systolic drop of BP should not be more than 10 mm of Hg. Okay. Should not be more than 10 mm of Hg. Or increase should not be more than 30 mm of Hg. Okay. If it is going beyond or coming to that range, you have to monitor the patient. Okay. You have to monitor his or her vitals. No heart rate increase beyond 12 with beta block, or no heart rate increase beyond 20 if not beta block. Okay, if they are on drugs, their heart rate should not increase more than 12 beats. Suppose it was 70 and after his exercise it has become 85, 86. That means difference is more than 12. You have to be cautious if they are on beta blockers. If they are not on beta blockers, suppose it was 70 and now it has become 105. It is shooting up. There is some problem. You need to inform the doctors. And complaints of dizziness, lightheadedness, or angina should be noted. Anytime if you feel dizzy or something, should be documented immediately. Talk to the physician who has referred to you. You say he's still feeling lightheadedness. Is everything okay? Blood report, blood volume, everything. You need to discuss with the physician. Mobilization will consist of all these exercises, okay, and followed by sternal precautions. All exercises that you are teaching to the patient, tell them at least 3 times a day you need to practice it to have an early recovery. Okay. And once they are getting discharged from the hospitals, you need to tell them please continue these exercises at home and meet me 3 times a week for the consultation in the OP. Okay, there you will be starting the treadmill exercise. Okay, so you have to give them an exercise program for home. Okay, so 3 days they will come to you, less 4 days, what are they going to do? Okay, so they should exercise at home, should give them a home exercise program. You should tell them the importance of warm up and cool down. What is important? Why you should warm up? Warm up is very important because it prepares the body for the exercise phase. During the exercise phase, the patient will not report of any kind of injury or problem. Okay. Cool down is important because the blood is almost in the center. So when we are cooling down, we are returning, the blood is almost in the periphery during the exercise. When we are cooling down, we are returning the blood from the periphery to the center or the heart. Okay. So these are the exercise thing. Okay. So this is full exercise protocol that you will follow in phase 2 and 3 in the outpatient department. Phase 4 is usually the maintenance. Okay, you tell them, see, you do exercise, meet me every 6 months or yearly, show me your report, show me your progress. Okay, so that's it.